can be solved like this way. This is the analysis. Now, first I have to identify the input size. Here the input size is very simple. It's nothing but the number of disk. That is nothing but n. If number of disk increases, it will take more time for shifting to the third peg. So the number of disk is the input size. Okay. And what is the basic operation? Basic operation is nothing but moving one disk from one peg to another peg. If you move one disk from one peg to another peg, that is nothing but the basic operation of this puzzle. Here, first I have to identify how many basic move operation occurs. That can be indicated by M of n. Here M of n indicates the number of moves by this basic operation to shift nth disk from disk 1 to disk 3. Okay, from disk 1 to disk 3, I have to move nth disk. How many basic operations I have to run? How many moves I have to run? That is indicated by M of n. Here M of n is nothing but, we can calculate here using this formula, M of n minus 1 plus 1 plus M of n minus 1, where n value is greater than 1. Here this M of n minus 1 indicates the basic operations, that is the number of moves from peg 1 to peg 2. Okay, to peg 1 to peg 1, peg 2, we need n minus 1 movement. Totally, I need n minus 1 movement. That is indicated by this M of n minus 1. And this 1 indicates the movement of nth disk. That is 1. Now, I am moving the nth disk from peg 1 to peg 3. This is 1. Here, M of n minus 1 indicates I have to move this n minus 1 disk from peg 2 to peg 3 by using this as the auxiliary. So this is the M of n minus 1 from moving from here to here. So this is explained here. So this is from peg number 1 to 2, and this is the peg number 1 to 3, the disk movement. And this is from peg 2 to 3. These number of movements occurs for a single movement of nth disk. Okay, to move one disk, I have to perform these number of movements. Okay, now then we have to identify the initial condition. What is the initial condition of the recursive operation? The initial condition is very simple here. When the n value becomes 1, that is nothing but M of n 1, its result is 1. So our recursive operation stops, our recursive algorithm stops when the n value becomes 1. That is, only one disk is there in the peg 1. So this is the formula I have to simplify it. Now what is the formula I got? M of n is nothing but 2m of n minus 1. How it is 2m of n minus 1? Very simple. M of n minus 1 plus M of n minus 1, it is nothing but 2m of n minus 1. And this plus 1 indicates this one. Now this is the initial condition. When you have only one disk, you just move it to the third peg. There is no need of any recursive operation here. This indicates that you have only one peg and you are moving from peg number 1 to peg number 3 without any recursive operation. This is for the remaining pegs if the n value is greater than 1. 2 disk, 3 disk. In this situation, we have to use this formula. Now, when you simplify it using some backward substitution technique, when you apply the backward substitution technique on this formula, okay, just imagine this is nothing but n. N minus 1 is nothing but n. And apply this using some backward substitution technique. Yeah, if you imagine this one as the n, n minus 1 is nothing but the n, you can make it as 2m, like this way, 2m. Now see, m of n is nothing but 2m, n minus 1 plus 1. It's nothing but here, 2m, n minus 1, minus 1 plus 1. Here, minus 1 becomes 2 here. Okay, when you substitute n with n minus 1, okay, one more n, 1, that is nothing but n minus 2 here. Okay, now this is the substitution. I just, instead of n minus 1, I apply this formula here. Now see, instead of n minus 1, when you substitute with 2m, n minus 2 plus 1, to this formula here, okay, plus 1 is this one, you got 2 raised to 2, m, n minus 2, because n minus 2 here, plus 2. This one, 1 plus 1, this is nothing but 2 here, not this one here, 2 into 1, it's nothing but 2, and this one is 1 here. Okay, like that, you substitute it. Once the substitution is done here, we have to one more substitution for this n minus 2. Instead of m of n minus 2, I can change it to, I apply the same formula here, I apply the same formula, you got 2m n minus 3 plus 1. Instead of this one, I will write 2m n minus 3 plus 1. Here, when you apply the same formula here, 2 raised to 2, 2m, n minus 3 plus 1. You change this, you pass it here. Plus 2 plus 1. It's nothing but 2 cube. 2 square into 2 is nothing but 2 cube. M, n minus 3. N minus 3 plus 2 square into 1 is nothing but 2 square here. 2 and 1. 2 and 1. Now, if you see this substitution properly, backward substitution, there is the one pattern is there. If you see properly, there is the one pattern. What is the pattern here? Now see, here it is 2 raised to 1, here it is 2 raised to 2, here it is 2 raised to 3. Okay, now see this one, n minus 2, n minus 3. Again see this part, here it's 1, nothing but 2 plus 1, it's nothing but 2 square plus 2 plus 1, it's nothing but 4 plus 2 plus 1. Okay, there's the one pattern is there. What is the pattern? Here it increment here. Now I can easily simplify it. Instead of this number, I can change it to some variable here. It's nothing but the pattern is 2 raised to I, okay, 2 raised to I, then m, then n minus I, instead of 3, I can write I, but 2 raised to 3, n minus 3 here, instead of that one, I will write 2 raised to I, m, n minus I, this one, plus 2 raised to I minus 1, plus 2 raised to I minus 2, like that, I can do up to 1. Okay, like that, I have one pattern here. Okay, now see this one in the next slide. When you see the pattern, it's look like this way here. Okay, now I can easily identify here. I can easily identify what may be the next pattern here. It's very simple. 2 raised to 4. When the I value becomes 4 here, next m here. Next one is n minus 4. Next one is plus 2 raised to 3 plus 2 raised to 2 plus 2 plus 1. Like that it continues. It's a simple pattern. Yes? So that is indicated here. M of n is nothing but 2 raised to I, m, n minus I, plus 2 raised to I minus 1 plus 2 raised to I minus 2, like that you have 2 plus 1. When you simplify this, it's nothing but 2 raised to I minus 1. You can give any value to this I and check it. It's nothing but 2 raised to I minus 1, this part. So this is the simplified formula for our algorithm. Okay, now what? Since the initial condition is n is equal to 1. Now instead of I, just imagine the I value is nothing but n minus 1. Because when you are when the n value is 1, means you have the last disk and you already shifted n minus 1 disk. To shift the last disk, you have already shifted the n minus 1 disk. So instead of I can change it to n minus 1. That is nothing but 2 raised to n minus 1. Wherever you have I, it's nothing but n minus 1. Okay. 2 raised to I becomes 2 raised to n minus 1. M n minus I becomes n minus 1 here. Plus 2 raised to I minus 1 becomes, 2 raised to I becomes here n minus 1. When you simplify it, you got like this one. Okay. When you simplify this formula here, it's nothing but here n goes cross out. We have only 1 here. Okay, positive 1. So m of 1 here. 2 raised to n minus 1, this becomes. Okay, it's nothing but 1. M of 1 is nothing but 1. So 2 raised to n minus 1 plus 2 raised to n minus 1 minus 1. That's nothing but 2 raised to n minus 1, 2 raised to n minus 1 minus 1 is nothing but 2 raised to n minus 1. It's nothing but exponential. This is a algorithm which is indicating exponential algorithms. That indicates if the number of disks increases, our problem or algorithms drastically increase its execution time. So we have to use less number of disks for this game. If the disk size is 10, 100, you cannot solve that problem within a fraction of seconds. It will take longer time, because it's an exponential algorithm.